Wait, is my hand good? Is it good?
Yeah, you're good.
All right.
When
are you filming?
Yeah, we're starting.
Three,
yeah, two.
Two, one. Hello! Today's show. Today we'll be learning about environmental science and how, importantly, we'll be learning about climate today as it appears to natural selection. So, climate is very important. So, what are some key factors about climate that we need to know? So. Oh, I didn't see you there. Oh, well, while you're here, critical factors. Well, let's talk about critical factors and tolerance levels. So, let's start with critical factors. Blimey, a bullet point. Climate. Okay, so we're going to be learning about climate today. Climate as it pertains to natural selection in animals. Now, all living organisms have to respond to climate, and climate affects every single animal. For example, temperature. The temperature of a cacti requirements to live are very high. The cacti must live in arid and hot environments, unlike the polar bear that must live in extreme cold conditions. Therefore, these are prime examples of animals and their tolerance limits in their climate. What? Another sheet of paper? A new diagram? Alright, I guess I should probably explain this diagram to you. Here you can see the optimal zones for a specific critical factor. In this section here, there is an abundance of a critical factor, and the life here survives very well and is very good. So we're going to give it a smiley face. On the outsides of the abundance, there is less of the critical factors in which an animal needs to survive, and therefore the animal does survive, but it's not as many and they don't survive as well. So we're going to give it a neutral face. But on the outskirts, this is the intolerance zones on these two edges. This is where life cannot exist because they don't have any of the requirements for life. And another thing you might be interested in learning about are environmental indicators. What are environmental indicators, I hear you ask? Well, let me give you an example. Fishermen know that trout need clean, fresh water to survive, and therefore the presence or absence of fresh, clean water directly related to the fish. If there are no fish, then the water is not clean. If there are fish, then it's clean, fresh water. And if you want to find out more, visit your local Apple store to get your iPhone today.
I can't see your head.